2011 is the hospice's 30th year, and I was reflecting on the way the hospice has grown and progressed over those 30 years. Relatively humble beginnings on this site, a small organisation, nearly all volunteers. Today we've got 87 staff, the budget's over 2 million, and we provide a fantastic service to the people of Halton. We've moved over the years to becoming increasingly professional, and this year in particular is a milestone for us, because we've got our inpatient unit being completely refurbished so that the facilities reflect the care that's given within them. Also this year, a consultant joins us for the first time, Dr. Avril Fountain, and she complements the four medical officers that we already have as part of our team. So a fantastic year, a fantastic birthday, and a great time to reflect on all the wonderful people and all the wonderful times that we've had so far.
Halton Haven Inpatients Unit has 12 beds, all of which have their own private room and ensuite facilities. At the Haven, we're able to care for people in the end-of-life stage of their illness, as well as complex management symptom issues. We also do rehabilitation, and we have physiotherapy available and complementary therapists available to assist those patients in their rehabilitation and end-of-life care. We also at the Haven have a family support unit who are able to give one-to-one counselling for just a two-minute chat, or even, you know, a one-to-one-hour session should need be. The family support unit are also there to assist clients with their young children should they have them, and also assist with welfare rights should they have any issues with finances. The hospice also has, as part of its team, a chaplain, and he helps with spirituality issues.
Day hospice is open 5 days a week during the time of 9 to 4:30. Basically what we do is we pick patients up who have palliative needs. We bring them in on a minibus that is actually driven by volunteers, and I escort myself in case anybody's not well. When they get here, they have therapies, they have consultation with our doctor, they're able to see other nurses and discuss a lot of things with us and that. We also can offer different things such as family support, and they have a lovely meal here with us every day. We join in, we have all kinds of like games and quizzes and anything that they can join in with, art, and basically just have a nice time. We have a good laugh most of the time, and they really enjoy coming. They only basically come for like 12 weeks, and then what we do is we medically review them to see if they need to stay longer, if they need any more help, or whether they can actually be discharged. Everyone who comes enjoys day hospice. I'm glad we're here for them, and we can help with lots and lots of things. Basically that's it, and then we take them home at 3 o'clock. Usually they only come one day a week. Occasionally if somebody needs more help, they can come twice a week.
Hi, I'm Kieran. I'm the events manager at Halton Haven Hospice. I look after all the major events that we put on throughout the year. For example, we've got the Twilight Walk and Light Up a Life. And this year we're hoping to incorporate a new event, the Santa Dash, in December. We're also looking to move ourselves into different catchment areas in our borough. I also work with the local businesses to help them support their corporate responsibility within the charity sector. So no matter how big or small your fundraising efforts are, please, it all helps provide our special kind of caring.
Over 3 years ago, we decided to develop our fundraising charity shops. We started off in Runcorn Old Town. We decided to start selling furniture, which was a great success. On the middle floor we had clothes, and on the top floor we decided to open a bridal shop. The store was very, very successful, and within a matter of months we decided we'd actually outgrown it. We couldn't get the furniture in and out quick enough, so we opened a retail unit down off Picker Farm Road. Again, within months we'd actually outgrown this, and the sales from the furniture was actually amazing. So we decided to actually go over to Widnes and open a charity shop over there. It's three floors, it's in the main centre of Widnes. On the first floor we've got furniture yet again, electrical goods. We've actually as well on the second floor got clothes, we've got a bookshop over there and a baby room. And actually the fundraising team are actually based over there as well, in the heart of Widnes. So we cover both sides of the town.
One of the most important parts of the hospice's success has been the fantastic support which we've had from the community. We get about 43% of our funding from the government. That leaves well over £1 million to find each year. And it's amazing how people find ways to generate money for us, to give of time. Without the community, this hospice wouldn't exist. We're part of the community, we care in the community, and the community it is that keeps us open. So we want to end by saying thank you so much to everybody over these last 30 years who's been involved in the success of the hospice. Absolutely wonderful to know that you, all of you, are part of our special palliative care.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, good night and God bless.